Welcome, exiles! In this video, we'll talk about how to make a build from scratch. I'm going to share my process of making a build and walk you through the creation of one of my builds. If you have time to watch long videos, I have a series called Let's Make a Build from Scratch, where I recorded the full process of making a build, well, from scratch. The videos in that series are a bit long, that is why I decided to make this video to summarize this process in hopefully 10 minutes. However, if you have time to watch those videos, you can find the link in the description. For our build creation, we are using a free awesome program called the Path of Building. I'm assuming you have basic knowledge of this program, and I'm going to talk about some more advanced things. If you don't have Path of Building installed, you can find the download link below. Know that I'm using Community Fork version since it has support for more items and build types. I will also link the guide that you can watch to learn the basics of Path of Building. So if you never used the Path of Building, go watch that video first, then come back to this video. With everything out of the way, let's get to the fun part where you actually learn how to make a build. This process can be broken down into few steps. The first step is research. Before we start doing anything, we have to answer a few questions. What is our main skill? What is our base class and ascendancy? Is our build going to use certain unique items? And what game mechanics is our build going to include? Note that those are not set in stone, but you have to have some starting point. I recommend you play around in Path of Building before you start leveling. Since once you have leveled the character, those things are expensive and time-consuming to change. For our example build, we're building around a unique item called One With Nothing Small Cluster Jewel. This jewel adds the Keystone Hollow Pump technique to your skill tree, and the Keystone gives you. You count as dual wielding while you are encumbered. 60% more attack speed while you are encumbered. 14 to 20 added physical damage per 10 dexterity while you are encumbered. The Keystone gives us damage based on how much dexterity we have. This type of build is called stat stacking, in this case, dex stacking. This item says that we have to be encumbered. This means we can't use weapons or gloves. While this seems like a big drawback, we get damage that can rival mirror tier weapons with just a bit of dex investment. One other drawback is that weapons give you bigger area of effect for your skills. This makes sense, since you're going to reach further with big two-handed dex than you're going to reach with bare hands. So our example build is going to be better at bossing, and maybe we can invest in area of effect or some other game mechanic to help with the clear speed. We need to do a bit more research to answer our other questions. So where do we start? My favorite place to find some inspiration for builds is POE Ninja website. This website shows the actual in-game characters that people are playing. When we type One With Nothing into a search filter, we can see that there are not many people that are using it. Just 0.1%. This makes it an off-meta build. This is usually good in my opinion, since items might not be as expensive, but also makes that if you are using some rare items with specific non-generic stats, you will have to make them yourself. People who craft items for profit usually only make them for popular builds, so they can sell them faster. In our example build, I ended up with a lot of uniques, so that's not an issue. For Ascendancy, the top 3 are Juggernaut, Raider and Gladiator. Some people went with Berserker, Chieftain, Slayer and Champion. You can see what items are most popular in the list where we added One With Nothing. The next most popular item is Fluid Motion, then the Watcher's Eye, Astramentis and so on. Next we can see that the most popular skills are Ice Crash, Cyclone and Earth Shatter. We can figure out what support skills are popular by selecting the main skill. You can see a new window below with a list of support skills. This can give you a good starting point for your game choice. One awesome thing to use is the passive 3-hit map. This is going to show you what other people are picking up in their skill tree. If you want to explore one of the builds further, you can import the build into Path of Building by copying POE code and pasting it in import section of Path of Building. POE Ninja is an excellent resource, I could spend even more time in this section. Maybe give you some other examples of different builds, but that would make this video way too long. So I recommend you go and explore different builds on POE Ninja. Try to figure out why people are playing some combination of items and skills. In my Let's Make a Build from Scratch series, I opted to use Cyclone as a main skill, and the ascendancy of choice is a champion. As you can see, there are no champions that are using One with Nothing and Cyclone. Why did I decide to do that? Well, I never played that combo, so I wanted to see if I can make something good out of it. At the end, nothing is set in stone. I can just redo my ascendancy and tweak my skill tree in the path of building. I recommend exploring all options before you level, so you don't waste too much time and currency on respecking and re-leveling. So let's recap our choices. Build enabling unique, One with Nothing small cluster jewel. Main skill, Cyclone. Ascendancy, Champion. Was there one more question? What game mechanics are we going to include in our build? Well, from my research, the best way to scale damage for Cyclone is Impale. Impale is a debuff that deals additional physical damage to affected target each time it is hit. When a hit applies Impale to a target, 10% of that hit physical damage is recorded before any damage mitigation is applied. Impale deals the recorded damage to the target each time it is hit. Impale remains in effect for 8 seconds or until the maximum number of hits is reached. By default, the Impale lasts 5 hits. A target may have multiple Impale's effects on it at once, all of which deal damage to the target each time it is hit. Well, that is a wiki description. If you're confused, Impale equals more physical damage. It's that simple. For defense, Champion Ascendancy gives decent armor, evasion and permanent fortify. So we can try to scale that. Those are just a few examples. The actual build includes few other mechanics to scale damage and defenses. I opted not to include everything since the video would be way too long. One thing that you really should avoid is including too many game mechanics into a build. Try to have one main skill. Two skills are also okay if one is for clear speed and one is for bossing. Scale only one type of damage. For defenses, first cap resist, get chaos resistance to zero, get physical damage reduction, you can use armor and endurance charges and few other things. Next, try to have one avoidance mechanic that is scaled high. That can be block, dodge or evasion. Try to get effective life pool to 5k plus, that can be life, energy, shield or even mana if you're using mind over matter. Know that there are builds that do not follow these rules and are still good, but you have to know what you're doing to make those builds. Try to stick with basics for your first builds. The next step is to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss when I upload new videos. Nah, just joking. That's not important, but it's highly appreciated if you do so. Moving on to the actual step 2. We're finally going to open the path of building. In this step, you're going to plug in all the information from your research into path of building. First, make a new build and save it. Don't forget to save often so you don't lose your work. Next, pick your class and ascendancy. For our example, that is Dualist and Champion. Add a build enabling unique if your build has any. For me, that is One with Nothing small cluster jewel. To do this, go to Items tab. In the search box, type in the name of the item. Double click the item, then click on Add to Build. Now, this specific item needs to be plugged into jewel socket at the outer edge of the skill tree, so I will do that next. Then add your main skill. To do this, go to Skills tab, make a new group, name it Main Skill. Then add Cyclone as your first gem. Next, as a placeholder, you can add supports that you found on POE Ninja. In my Let's Make a Build series, I used one other strategy to figure out what are the best supports. The idea is, if you have good base damage to scale, Path of Building will suggest the best support gems. So first scale the damage, then get back to the adding supports. Since we're not using weapons or spells, we have to add some base dexterity so the path of building can start calculating our DPS properly. We'll do that by adding some base rare items. Go to items, craft item, pick what item slot is the item for, and just add life as a prefix and dexterity as a suffix. You can make them perfect if you want, or something realistic. At this point it does not matter that much. I opted to go for tier 2, I think. Repeat this process until you fill all the slots. For any other build, you just add stats that the build would use. I would not add resist since you can't really buy or craft exact items that you have in path of building. You'll sort that out in game. Since this build is a bit funky, we go back to the main skills again to fill in the supports. You will see that path of building suggests exactly the same supports we found on POE Ninja. So if you're wondering if people who make builds have a high IQ and mad degree to calculate these things, well, now you know, they don't. I do, however, have an engineering degree, so I might have an edge in that. But really, anyone can just pop a path of building and let it do the work. In some cases, you have to use your brain since the path of building does not calculate everything. Now, these steps don't have to go in this order. Feel free to experiment and go back and forth. But the next thing that you can do is jump into skill tree and start playing around. My recommendation is to use node power. Tick the box and pick what you want highlighted for your build. We are scaling impels, so I would select impel plus total DPS. Next, tick the power per point. You can also look at power report. This is probably the most fun part of making build, just play around and see what nodes are going to give you the most damage or defenses. Next, what you can do is pick some unique items to replace those rares. You can also let path of building do some work for you. Just select what stats to look for, as said for our build, that is impel plus total DPS. Now, there might be some better options than what path of building is suggesting, but this is a good start. You can also poke builds on POE Ninja for some ideas, and maybe if all else fails, just look at uniques on POE Wiki to find something interesting. Go back to the previous step to see if you can tweak the skill tree next. Add the auras and support skills, try adding some cluster jewels into the mix. Then you can try replacing uniques with expensive rare items. This is usually really expensive, but see if something is worth it. You can use Craft of Exile to see the odds of rolling the mods, and just checking the prices on Path of Exile trade if those items exist already and how expensive they are. And finally, keep experimenting until you make something good. When you made something good in Path of Building, it's time to go in game and test it. Level up a build and see what needs more work. Well, something is not going to work even if you put a lot of effort into preparing a build. So you will have to tweak it further. Don't just randomly change things in game. Go back to the path of building and test before you change things. I recommend importing your character into the path of building for further work. To make a perfect build, you will have to repeat last two steps many times. I hope you make a crazy good build. If you did, share it. Don't just keep it for yourself. Generate a paste bin and make a forum post for your build, or make a video like I do. It's a lot of fun to make builds, but it's more fun to share them and work with other people to make them even better. I hope you have some idea where to start with your build. I try to make this video not as long and still provide as much information as I can. If you want to learn more, you can give my Let's Make a Build from Scratch series a go. I know we just covered one type of build, but I did not want to go too crazy in this video. I plan to make more videos on this topic. Some ideas for videos are various ways to scale damage and defenses, talking about game mechanics and how to build around them. If you start making something, feel free to leave me a comment anytime if you have some questions. I'm always happy to talk about builds. Well, exiles, good luck with your future builds, and I will see you in the next one.